Welcome to Lecture 7 for CED 405, Spiritual Formations. Today's lecture is going to be on telling your story. In Acts chapter 1, verse 8, Jesus said, "And ye shall be witnesses unto me." Simply put, a witness is one who tells what he or she has seen or experienced. The most basic form of evangelism, and perhaps the most effective, is simply telling others what Jesus has done in your own life. Now, since there is so much power in our personal testimony, we should work on giving it as clearly as possible. With that in mind, let's start with Roman numeral 1, powerful benefits to sharing your personal testimony. The first powerful benefit is that your personal testimony is difficult to refute. While obviously not impossible, one's personal testimony is difficult to refute on account of it ultimately being an individual's personal experience and not necessarily something concrete and measurable. But not only because of that, but letter B, people can relate to personal experiences. So many people are going through what you and I went through and eventually what brought us to Christ. Sharing your testimony can help others not only relate to your experiences, but also see a pathway to help and victory. And then finally, letter C, even a new believer can give their personal testimony. Now, while a new believer may not be able to recite the Apostles' Creed or the Romans Road, he or she can easily tell others how they decided to trust in Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Now that we've discussed the powerful benefits of a personal testimony, let's look deep into an example of a powerful testimony that Paul the Apostle gave himself. In Acts chapter 26, in verses 4 through 11, Paul began by telling about his life before Christ. Verse 4 says, "My manner of life from my youth, spent from the beginning among my own nation and in Jerusalem, is known by all the Jews. They have known for a long time, if they are willing to testify, that according to the strictest party of our religion, I have lived as a Pharisee. And now I stand here on trial because of my hope in the promise made by God to our fathers, to which our 12 tribes hope to attain, as they earnestly worship day and night. And for this hope, I am accused by Jews, O King. Why is it thought incredible by any of you that God raises the dead? I myself was convinced that I ought to do many things in opposing the name of Jesus of Nazareth, and I did so in Jerusalem. I not only locked up many of the saints in prison after receiving authority from the chief priests, but when they were put to death, I cast my vote against them. And I punished them often in all the synagogues and tried to make them blaspheme. And in raging fury against them, I persecuted them even to foreign cities." Then, after going into great detail about his life before Christ, Paul then told about how he received Christ. Paul continued in verse 12 by saying, "In this connection, I journeyed to Damascus with the authority and commission of the chief priests. At midday, O King, I saw on the way a light from heaven, brighter than the sun, that shone around me and those who journeyed with me. And when we had all fallen to the ground, I heard a voice saying to me in the Hebrew language, 'Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? It is hard for you to kick against the goads.' And I said, 'Who are you, Lord?' And the Lord said, 'I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. But rise and stand upon your feet, for I have appeared to you for this purpose, to appoint you as a servant and witness to the things in which you have seen me and to those in which I will appear to you, delivering you from your people and from the Gentiles, to whom I am sending you, to open their eyes so that they may turn from darkness to light and from the power of Satan to God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and a place among those who are sanctified by faith in me. Next, after Paul told about his life before Christ and then how he directly received Christ, he told of the difference Christ has made in his life. Continuing in verse 19, Paul said, "Therefore, O King Agrippa, I was not disobedient to the heavenly vision, but declared first to those in Damascus, then in Jerusalem, and throughout all the region of Judea, and also to the Gentiles, that they should repent and turn to God, performing deeds in keeping with their repentance. For this reason the Jews seized me in the temple and tried to kill me. To this day I have had the help that comes from God, and so I stand here testifying both to small and great, saying nothing but what the prophets and Moses said would come to pass, that the Christ must suffer, and that, by being the first to rise from the dead, he would proclaim light both to our people and to the Gentiles." And then finally, in verse 27, Paul concluded with a question of invitation. Here he says, "King Agrippa, believest thou the prophets? I know that you believe." Interestingly, Paul's entire testimony only lasted about 3 minutes. And if you look at letter F, here we can see how Paul delivered his personal testimony. He began by discussing his life before he met Christ. Then he moved into his actual conversion. After that, he talked about how Christ had changed his life. And then finally, he ended with a concluding question to try to draw King Agrippa to know the same Jesus to whom had been revealed to him. By using Paul's example and his blueprint of telling his personal testimony, let's look at Roman numeral 3, telling your personal testimony. Letter A, begin by talking about your life before Christ. Here, you will answer the question, where were you spiritually before you received Christ, and how did that affect you? What were your feelings, your attitudes, your actions, and your relationships? Now, if you were saved as a young child, I would encourage you to start with question number 2. What caused you to begin considering receiving Christ as your Savior? After answering these questions, let's move on to letter B. How did you receive Christ? The first question here that you will answer is, what realization did you come to that finally motivated you to receive Jesus as Lord and Savior? And then secondly, in detail, describe how you received Christ. And then finally, letter C. How has your life been since receiving Christ as Savior? Number 1, how did your life begin to change after you received Jesus? And then secondly, what blessings have come to your life since becoming a Christian? And again, if you were saved as a young child, answer these last 2 questions by contrasting your life to what it might have been like without Christ. And then finally, number 3, write a question that would cause a response from the listener. Just like Paul did, you want to elicit some type of response by the individual or individuals you are talking to. With all of that in mind, let's move on to the actual assignment you have for this class, and that is writing your personal testimony. Letter A, here are some tips to writing your testimony. Number one, be very specific about the details on how you received Christ. Secondly, as already mentioned, always end your testimony with a question that causes a response. Thirdly, and very importantly, learn to use biblical truth in simple language that lost, unchurched people will understand. In other words, avoid using Christianese, phrases and expressions that only Christians really understand. And then fourthly, use scripture in your testimony that had an impact on your salvation. But you do not necessarily have to use book, chapter, and verse, since that may confuse the person you are talking to. Fifthly, make sure Christ is the most important person in your testimony. Your testimony should not be all about you. It should be all about what Jesus has done for you. And lastly, be sure to apply your testimony to the listener's specific situation. Now, specifically for your assignment on writing your personal testimony, make sure you type out your testimony in three paragraphs that follow the outline we learned from the Apostle Paul. That would mean your first paragraph will be about your life before you received Christ as Savior. The second paragraph will be a detailed explanation of how you received Christ. And the third and final paragraph will be about how your life has been changed ever since coming to know Jesus. Secondly, keep your typed testimony to about 450 to 500 words. And make sure you include your word count at the bottom of your testimony. This 450-500 word count will help your testimony to be between 3 to 5 minutes when you read it out loud. From this lecture, make sure you watch workshop number 3 in order to know what you will need to do next after typing your personal testimony. With that in mind, that brings us to the end of Lecture 10 for CED 405, Spiritual Formations.